In this video, we'll look at how to use index and match with an Excel table. Using index and match with an Excel table is wonderfully straightforward. To illustrate, I'll build index and match formulas that do the same thing as the VLOOKUP formulas already on this worksheet. First, to recap, the VLOOKUP formulas currently retrieve information from Table 1 based on the ID provided in K4. Each formula uses the lookup value from K4, the entire table for a table array, and the match function to figure out what column number to return based on the column names in column J. The last argument is false to force an exact match. If I change the ID, the formulas return information for a different employee. I'll start off by creating a copy of this structure to the right. Then I'll remove the formulas. A simple way to build out an index and match formula is to start with index only and hard code the row and column numbers. For array, I'll use the entire table. For row number, I hard code 5 since ID 622 corresponds to row 5 in the table. For column index, I use 2, since first name is the second column. With this information, index correctly returns John. If I copy the formula down and change the column number to 3, I'll get John's last name. Now all I need to do is replace the hard-coded values with match. To get the row number, I use match with N4 as the lookup value. I need to lock this because I don't want this to change. The array is the ID column of the table, and match type is 0 for exact match. The row number now works. To get column number, I use match again. This time, the lookup value comes from column M. The array is the table header. And match type is again 0 for exact match. And now I have a set of working formulas that work just like the VLOOKUP version. However, index and match offers one big advantage. Unlike VLOOKUP, the lookup value doesn't need to be in the first column. If I move the ID column in the table, the VLOOKUP formulas stop working, but the index and match formulas continue to work just fine.